Hello, I'm Tanner Glenn. For as far as we can tell, the sole purpose of human existence is to kindle a light in the darkness of mere being. Those who do wrong unto others will soon have wrong done to them. When is enough enough? Hate, violence, intolerance, and bigotry. At times it seems that we are told we live in a society where no one cares and the media tells us to be afraid. The division in this country, or so we are told, is at an all-time high. No country in the world has sacrificed and gained as much as we have. America may be the greatest country in the world, but that doesn't mean there is no room for improvement. This is a country with the greatest legal system in the world, yet it has the highest rate of wrongful convictions in the world. A country that's foundation was built upon innocent until proven guilty, yet fosters a system that at times coins nearly any person of interest as guilty until proven innocent. The core foundations of the nation were to be life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. To fight tyranny, not become the tyrant. To stand up for those who can't stand up for themselves. But what are we to do when faced with a situation where wrongdoing is clear and present, but may be protected by a false shield such as religion, hypocrisy, connection, status, money, fame, or a badge? Since when does one person's word outweigh others, and how does someone's word carry more weight than another's by nothing more than a title? Nearly any woman can become a mother, but not all can be a mom. Most men can become fathers, not all of them are dads. Some are preachers, but in no way set an example any just God could be proud of. There are a lot of people in every position available on this earth that shouldn't be in it for a number of reasons. But what may be worst of all is that there are humans with no humanity. We live in a world where our day-to-day actions and ingenuity cries out for the unity and advancement of mankind. Deep down, we want progress and brotherhood, yet we see so many people fall into and stand idle in a state of paralysis while in the presence of acts of greed, hate, and intolerance. It seems that the opinion of a few dictate the path of the people. Why is it that nobody wishes there's a third party until it gets down to two people? It seems that if one possesses money, power, or the major forms of communication that they control, and all others must accept. Humans were never created to be ruled by anyone other than themselves. Those who hate themselves hate humanity and spread dissent among those around them. We must never allow ourselves to get into this hate. For in the Bible it is said that the kingdom of God is within man. No single person or group was meant to have power over all others. Before I understood the ways of the world, I used to think that liars should not lie. But of course they should. That's why they are called liars. I say that cheaters shouldn't cheat. But of course, that's why they're called cheaters. But just because the losers always lose doesn't mean that every now and again you can't secure a win. This is a wicked mess, be cruel, the good will always be great. The nurses will always heal, teachers will always teach, doctors prescribe, the law will be upheld, the right will never be wrong. If it makes sense, I'll be back.